thanks again for doing this for everybody. I'd start by a quick question where I think everybody would agree that B.P.R.D. is one of the most consistently successful books, both in the writing and the artwork and the colors all working together. And I was curious if, over the course of these years, what some of the most difficult creative differences you've had, how you're working them, how you guys actually did, you know, and all on the same page in a time when you guys have never really disagreed over something.
My feeling is I put it so firmly in John's hands, and we do talk about stuff a lot, so we're kind of gently, I kind of gently suggest we'll go this way. That's really the direction we have to change from probably the first time we talked about it. It's kind of evolved in a particular direction, and I feel like we're both kind of simply going, wow, that's working out pretty good. It's like we're growing this thing.
I know that, like, nothing major. They're not even too many small disagreements, really.
Not too good. Guys, you know, there's some design things when we went back and forth. There was never really a major disagreement.
That's like you're growing.
Yeah, it's just that we've got the time to back stuff back and forth. There may be some design things like that in the giant penis month. It took a while to figure out what that thing was supposed to look like. That's what we settled on.
Right off the bat, I've
really made her my favorite character. Probably even more so than Hellboy. Which is saying a lot because I love Hellboy, especially the new drama. So I just want to thank you for not just thinking only about these flashy characters with these powers and these fantasy hooks. It shows that you care about them. And so, although I'm not buying a lot of other things, you put out a key card and the book and the
add it to the list. And this is John. Because John and neither John or I are really superhero guys. So I think the tendency in comics to make an interesting character is it's a character whose head is invisible or you know can fire this beam out of this or you know whatever. And what John is the best at is making people interesting. You know, and the relationship between these characters. Because the evil one guy's gas. In a bag, he does have a human mind, and he is a human being, so you treat him like a human being, to some extent.
Kate's frustration since she's moved up to the UN and everything has been really
bad. Yeah. Thank you.
I just have kind of a weird one. I was wondering if maybe you had any desire to do a standalone or even a short run that's set entirely during the first race of man, way back in Hyperborea and things like that. I'm always fascinated when you do thrillers.
I would love to do it. Love to do it. Because again, that's part of the whole Hellboy thing. This is where, you know, the book kind of snowballs because we have, we're dropping in these little bits of the history of the world from, you know, prehistory up to now. So you kind of go, oh, there's a lot of ground to cover. But yeah, the prehistoric stuff, I would love to do something with that.
I would love to see it. So.
Don't
get my phone.
This actually goes back to a comment about Mask, John Arcudi, wonderful series along with Mickey Bummer. And I was wondering if there was any chance that Bet Monkey would ever be working with you guys on this franchise in any capacity. Yeah, but he's totally tied up to Time Warner.
He's exclusive with DC, yeah. And he's got a baseball team for kids, so he's he's not going anywhere, I guess. I've talked with him again on anything, believe me, but that's...
Well, good luck.
Thanks.
In King of Fear, Liz had the apocalyptic vision of the future where she saw future possible aim, but then there was that photograph with Hellboy and the B.P.R.D. came. So
it's amazing how few people mention
that. Yeah, I was surprised with that. I thought this would be the first question. And then when Hellboy had the thing in the pub with during the storm where he says, I need to go back to the B.P.R.D., is this just wishful thinking? Or do you think, I know you can't say it wasn't actually.
We'll have to read the book. Yeah, it's unfortunately, it's really hard to say anything without giving things away, but next year you'll see a lot of major changes.
Yeah, because discussing with the board members, we always talk about possible futures and stuff for it, and like I personally don't see how Hellboy could go back, because it seems like it would defeat the BPRD book if Hellboy's back in it, so to me this seems like it's wishful thinking on Hellboy's part, except for maybe the very end.
Thanks again for coming. Just to tell you, I had not picked up a comic book graphic novel for 20 years until someone gave me your work, and I've not said, so thank you.
Oh, thank you.
I'm curious, the fact that you've been doing this for quite a while now with this consistent, I'm not real sure. I know you've been doing this for a while, but for how long? It's been interesting to see the evolution of your work and to see how things have changed. Do you find that's an organic process? How you write, how you draw, or do you say, you know, I want to simplify this, or I want to change it this way? What are is that natural? Does it just happen?
Well, it is evolution, but it's a conscious evolution in a way. I mean, it's for me, it's trial and error. You know, it's that didn't really work. Maybe I'll try a different way of drawing this, or in the pre-Dave Stewart days, you know, wow, that color is that open space, they're going to do something horrible there, so I'll fill it in solid black. You know, a lot of that spotty black came from seeing this hideously colored and marble. You know, you're page 50% black, but if the color color spills in the rest yellow and pink, it's an Easter egg. I remember maybe 98%
And I've seen this with your work where, you know, the early stuff was a lot more dialogue, a lot more detail. And as time went on, it became much more, I had to be invested intellectually with my imagination to really get it. I didn't know if that was your rush.
No, it's not a rush. Believe me, this stuff doesn't, none of the changes in my work have been done to make it go faster, because it goes slower. You know, if you only use four lines, it's got to be in the exact right place. I wish I was doing it for speed, but it's just, you know.
And it's good, it's not a bad thing, it's just interesting to see. Last quick question, no more Hellboy animated.
There's no talk of any Hellboy.
Because there was a teaser thing in the last one, I was like, please.
It would have been the best one.
I adore it, so it's, they met Doug Jones last year, and he was like a witch. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Hello, I was just wondering, this is a bit of a thing. There's a mystical creature who was called the Evergrey, I think. I'm not sure. You know, the guy with the green face, and he's also a detective. I'm just going to say it. That's something you can't answer.
It would seem highly unlikely that there's two guys named Evergrey in the same thing. It's probably the same guy, and you'll find out eventually, maybe, how the two are related. It's definitely in the works, the thing that connects those characters. So, yeah, I guess it's pretty likely that it's the same guy.
Just want to say
thank you.
Awesome.
I was really ready to give up on a lot of comic stuff.
That's funny, because when Tyler did his first piece with Johan, he gave him this really strange shaped head, because guys, Johan is so animated, I had to explain to Tyler, it's actually a solid plastic thing. You know, once you're moving him, and then you can play with his head, and you're just doing this one shot, I needed to kind of show Tyler where the head is. But yeah, I mean, you made that character. I mean, that's why you kind of made all those characters. So.
We should do one last question.
Hi. If you guys haven't had the opportunity to do what you guys are doing today, I mean, would you guys be teachers, researchers? I mean, thank goodness you guys got into this business, but where else do you guys see yourself? I mean, in life.
Oh, I wasn't doing.
Yeah.